First mass start of the season. Well, not only have we got an enthusiastic crowd here, Mike, it's quite nice. It's quite nice to hear some different music, and I think the choice has been good so far.
I thought it's a lovely blend. I love it just before the start. And in fact, all the way through, and the spectators, Koukalová is going to feel the pressure every millimeter of her race.
Somehow, she's got to learn to feed off the crowd. It's not easy, but if she's ever going to win here in Nove Mesto, she has to do exactly that. Oh, well, here's a look at the tracks.
Very simple journey, isn't it? Just under the bridge, up the first climb, you've got that 15, 20 second recovery, long drop down before the final climb, up and back into the range. But of course, they're doing that twice before the first shoot. Then after that, it'll be one more rotation in between each of the three remaining shots.
I was just checking my map. That, to me, looked like the 2.5 kilometer loop, so I'm not sure that they changed the graphic for the screen. So I'm half expecting the decision to have been reversed, and they may well have added a little bit of snow, but the course map we have does not tie in with the one that we've just seen on the screen. Well, there's your start list. But remember, it's different from the pursuit in that they all go together. That's why it's called a mass start. It's the latest addition to the biathlon races. It's been around a while. Maybe some would argue that we need another race just to liven things up. But there's no doubt that the mass start is here to stay. It is a fabulous competition. The top 30 effectively starting, top 25 in the World Cups, plus the five best performances here from athletes who are not in that top, those top positions in the World Cup. So everyone on form is in the lineup. Can France make it four wins in succession? Can they make it five wins out of the six here in Nove Mesto? Of course, Akimova, who got the win in the women's sprint. Here we go. There's Akimova.
Well, the final nervous moments, they've been through their warm-up, they've been through the zeroing of the rifles. Now it's the nervous lineup on the grid.
Now, obviously, a slight advantage to those who have been seeded because they start on the front row of the grid. And this little bit of snowfall is going to change things a little. Now, they're all going at the same time, and I suspect they've all got skis prepared for damp tracks. But if it gets any heavier than this, there won't be a huge advantage in leading out. In fact, it will be a distinct disadvantage. So we may see some of the favored names sitting a bit further back in the pack where the snow's pressed down a little for the first loop anyway. After the first shoot, well, you take your position and you run from there. Kaisa Mäkäräinen, in her prime, she could ski away from anyone. Marie Durand-Hébert. Surprisingly few World Cup wins, Durand-Hébert, but she is one for the major championships. She always seems to be able to raise her game. Justine Brézard, the new talent in the French team, just 20 years old. One or two shaky moments on the range, but she skied herself out of trouble on most occasions this year. A half smile. 99% focus, though, from Laura Dahlmeier. Macarainen looks as though she wants a good start in the middle in the white suit, and she gets away very quick indeed. Can't be matched by Durana Bear, and there'll be a good build-up of speed. You want a nice position coming out of the stadium. Laura Dahlmeier's gone hard as well in the yellow bib, but it's going to be Macarainen who leads down that right-hand turn under the stadium stands and out onto the first climb of this course. Expect to see the better skiers going hard from the early stages.
Well, we didn't see many falls, stumbles or trips in the men's competition. When you have 30 athletes all fighting, vying for position here, often there are trip-ups on the descents. We sometimes see falls. Remember the World Championships here when Flatland was in second place in this race, the mass start. Coming into the towards the finish, and she fell from first to eighth. She went.
You know what, Mike? If the athletes do protest at the World Championships being taken to Tumen in what was it, 2021?
Yes.
It's a no-brainer as to where it should come.
Well, they were in the running. The Czech Republic put themselves forward for 2021, and absolutely. Just heard the British Biathlon Union have made the decision that they will not attend the World Cup in March in Tumen, and I think that's a good stance to take, and I think lots of national federations will follow. I hope so.
Yeah, I don't think we've seen a crowd like this, as enthusiastic as this, since we were here in 2013. It is just brilliant.
And all the athletes saying at the press conference and talking, all the athletes just loving the atmosphere here. It makes the racing a joy. And it's also motivating to know that so many spectators are here to watch you race.
Well, Justine Brazar is not hanging back. She wants to hurt the big names. She's on the left of your screen, leading the way at the moment. Macarainen leading that right-hand column, number two. Number seven is Dorothea Wierer, the best of the Italians. And then Vitkova of the Czech Republic's done well. She's worked her way up into the third group. She's skiing alongside Gabi Koukalová. And the Czechs with Koukalová, Vitkova, and, of course, Puskarčíková, who's wearing eight. Haven't picked her out yet. I think Puskarčíková actually has dropped back a few places in the early stages.
What about Dahlmeier? I'm a little surprised. She had the best run out of the stadium, but they're in about 10th position.
But Dahlmeier, Mike, in life and on the tracks, she does her own thing.
She does, doesn't she? But today, I wonder what the team orders were. I thought they would be stay up in the top three, keep out of trouble, just do your normal. But she finds herself, I think, uncomfortably. In fact, it's eighth position at the moment.
Durana Bear tucking in behind her teammate, Justine Brazar. And just looking further down the order. Well, there's not much between the leaders at the moment, but every time we come to an uphill, the margin between first and last increases.
Well,
now Laura Dahlmeier just raising the pace a little. This is a long, sustained climb.
She very easily, that was eighth to first in an instant. Dahlmeier skis are gliding beautifully well. And that's always a feel-good factor.
Brazar looks strong, Mike, for a 20-year-old there in second place. You know, we've heard about her, of course, but we haven't watched her intensely over the last couple of seasons. So very nice to see a fresh name who can challenge the might of Koukalová and Macarainen in terms of ski speed. Koukalová playing it sensible, I think, at the moment. She knows that all she has to do, in effect, all she's got to change is her performance on the range, because that's not been good so far this week. And Koukalová, if she can hit 20 out of 20, she'll know she'll be in the mix for a top three.
I do wonder what's happened to Koukalová. Last year we could safely say, you know, she was the most reliable, especially in shooting, especially in the prone. That's not a good place to fall.
Number 24 has gone down. That's Heike of Switzerland. And she's taken out Franziska Hildebrand of Germany, number nine. So those two have lost some places. But as we said this morning, if you're going to make a mistake or if something's going to happen, make sure it happens early on, because then you've got a chance to make up for it. If it happens on the penultimate loop, and certainly if it happens on the last loop, you are out of the race.
Well, Brazar, you mentioned how comfortable she looks on her skis. She just looks at ease, absolutely efficient on her skis. and leading the way at the moment.
Who can block it out? Did you ever wear earplugs?
Never did.
Judging by your hearing now, no.
Exactly. I think it's a good move. Of course, first time they're just skiing straight through. Or some tempted to have a little rest. It's unusual, isn't it? 4 kilometers is because of the lack of snow, the track structure.
Well, I'm surprised that all 30 athletes are still within some 15 seconds of each other. I thought the strongest would try and capitalize on this long first lap. Maybe we'll see them accelerate when they go up the climb for the second time. Tyrolekov still in there. There is the fall. And of course, that was Lena Heike of Switzerland taking a time. I still didn't pick out quite what went wrong.
It seemed like her ski tip on her left foot just got nudged, got pushed over, and it brought her down.
Well, if Johannes Tingisbo can take a tumble and lose his chance of taking a top three, then anyone can fall.
Now, this is where I thought those who have the faster track time should try and break, do some more damage to the rest of the field, because 4 kilometers is a large distance before the first shoot.
Brezard going well, Amonier going well. That's been one of the features of this season, that generally all the French team have picked their speed up. I'm trying to remember the French women's biathlete who retired because she just couldn't compete, but she shot so well. It's on the edge of the tip of my tongue. It will come.
My brain is going through all the old files.
Fastest shot, the best shot, but just couldn't get near the podium.
Brunet.
Marie-Laure Brunet. One to you.
She just got frustrated, didn't she? Yeah. Just, you have to have the ski speed. Even like Brunet, where you had one of the best shots in the world, you still need to be competitive on your skis. Brezard nearly taking a tumble out of the tunnel.
Brezard leading, Amonier in second, three French in the top six at the moment. There's Gabi Koukalová in a nice position just ahead of Dorothea Wierer. The cameramen have been super busy all weekend, getting some great shots here at Nove Mesto, particularly when they've been racing under floodlights. And I think that's the answer for the Thursday, Friday. Have evening races. Give people a chance to finish up in the office and come down the stadium to watch.
Yeah, it's worked so well. And look at these fans in the far in the distance there, far distance. They're all around the track. They're only seeing some action every 5 minutes.
Well, that was Dorothea Wierer going down, and that was not her fault. I think someone's skiing over her basket, and that could, you know, if it doesn't pull the strap off your hand or the arm out of your shoulder, your only option is to go down and stop dead. So Dorothea Wierer's dropped right back, lost all her speed.
That's annoying, very annoying.
There
for
she is. She's up. Back on her feet, but what, 7, 8, 9 places lost.
Up quickly. On this next descent, I think we'll see Dahlmeier once again going from fourth up into the to the front of the pack. I think her skis are going, gliding fantastically well today.
It's easy to say it's the skis, Mike. We know about the slipstream. The other effect that we don't talk about so much is the effort you put in at the top of the hill, the top of the downhill. If you drive for 15 meters over the crest of the hill, you're going to be going that much faster, and you'll carry that speed all the way to the bottom and up the first section of the next uphill.
Well, Dahlmeier, once again, that's got to fill her with confidence. Yes, she puts in a few cheeky little skates, which bring more momentum to her movement down the hill.
Amonier showing Laura Dahlmeier no respect at all, and that's quite right. Nice and bold. Dahlmeier trying to force her way through. She's on the inside line, though, for the next corner, which will be handy. Three French women now in the top five. Makarainen's there. Tyrolekov is there, as we would expect. But if Tyrol's going to stay with the leaders, she's got to improve her shooting dramatically. Ranked number 17 in the world at the moment, Tyrolekov. Her shooting stats 77 and 71 in the prone and stand, respectively.
Dorothea Wierer, she's had to work hard to pull that gap, that deficit, after her fall.
Was that Vanessa Hinz picking up a spare pole? I think it was.
I don't know why, but I was feeling good about Vanessa Hinz today. I know she's ranked she's 23rd in the world at the moment. Hasn't gone all her way in the previous 8 races this season.
I still don't understand how the French didn't win the relay in Pokljuka.
Give us a tune.
Oh!
He's got rain in his trumpet.
I think he's had a few glue vines myself. There's plenty of that being consumed in between the races. Lots of entertainment tents behind the stands. It's a really friendly atmosphere.
And I like the way they put the new scaffolding there to create the bridge, the spectators above the tunnel as you ski into the range.
So the leaders as they come in, Amonier, Brizard, Dalmar, Makarainen, Duranabert, Laukkanen of Finland has done well. So two Finns up in the leading group as well. We've still only got some 12 seconds separating the top 25. We've got 24 within 10 seconds. They take the lane that corresponds with their bib number. I'm slightly surprised they didn't change that rule for the first shoot.
A little surprising, but the next time it's an open range filling in from the right, from lane one.
And as they stop early, some of those down the far end of the range, the likes of Vitkova going well. There's the first miss from the Czech. Now keep an eye on Koukalová's targets. We should see a cheer if she works through them. Dalmar with two misses. Duranabert, Makarainen, and Brezar all missing. Koukalová has one remaining, one round remaining. Down it goes. She stays in the top five, certainly. Puskarčíková, Hildebrand, Akimova, who's having a sensational weekend. She's clear. Skardino is clear. Petrushina is clear. But Mike, again, if you're going to make a mistake, make it early in the first shoot, because Dalmar will be back. Do not write her off quite yet.
She will be back, we'd expect, but her shooting in the prone has been a weakness this season, without a doubt. Last three seasons, she's been so reliable in the prone. Only 12, shooting the perfect 5 out of 5, first time.
Makarainen off the penalty loop, and it's cost her 32 seconds. Tyrylekov, one lap for her. Beskon, Zima, Vishnevskaya, San Filippo, all doing a penalty loop, and it's costly. Laura Dahlmeier is still there. She is going to be at least 40 seconds behind. It could be closer to 50. It is closer to 50. 51.4, the margin for Laura Dahlmeier. Now, let's see where they went. First one is okay.
4 o'clock. Oh, 5 o'clock. So all her shots. I thought the first one was low right as well. Her sights need to be raised. 4 clicks up, 3 clicks left. She'll get that information surely out on the track.
Well, the chase is on, and that's the sort of scenario we want. And similar to the one we had in the men's race, although Martin Fourcade only missed one early. And he didn't have too much trouble closing the gap down and taking the lead again with a sensational first standing shoot. Good burst coming in from Franziska Preuss, who's gone past Gabi Sukalova. Just behind her is Akimova, the winner of the first event here, the women's sprint. And she looked very, very quick. Actually, on skis, Mike, Akimova looked a match for anyone out there.
She did. She had certainly a lot of energy, a lot of drive. Her technique was good. And normally, we've seen in historically, the Russians' females' technique has been quite stiff, very little movement. They never put a lot of focus on technique in the past. Looks like they are now. What about Lisa Teresa Hauser? There she is at the front. She just makes it look so easy on the shooting range. 91% hit rate in the prone, 88 in the stand.
Keeps the elbows fairly close into the body compared to many. It's a strong looking position. A lot of people let the elbows rise up at the side, but she's trying to use the tricep as efficiently as she can. And of course the lats, the latissimus dorsi that runs down the side of the back, one of the major muscle groups. And Lisa Teresa Hauser, the only one using skate two, apart from, just trying to see, I think that was Vanessa Hinz going through. It was Vanessa Hinz, 23. Skardino from Belarus, 21. 25 is Petrushina for the Ukraine, and she's some way off. Let's just update ourselves on Dahlmeier, who did two penalty loops, remember. The last we saw, she was 51.4 behind the race leaders, and she's not gone through 4.9 as yet. So she's at least 50 seconds behind.
What surprised me is six athletes have missed two targets along with Dahlmeier.
Dahlmeier's dropped a further 3.5 seconds, Mike. And it's all because this lady is turning on the power. Lisa Teresa Hauser, she's showed a lot of promise this year. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw her get a win at some time this season. The crowd are going to love the fact that Koukalová is in second place. And the Czech Republic also have Puskarčíková up in that leading group.
Koukalová, she just needs to, as she did the previous time, the zero shoot, just same position, same routines.
You know, you never get support like this at the Olympics.
It's incredible. Look, they're not going to see much more of the race apart from this section, but there's 10, 15 deep along the track side. Lovely little board there showing the fall of the shot.
So they have put two huge screens on that climb, Mike, which has encouraged people to go out on the tracks. That's vitally important.
There's me saying, oh, they're not going to see much. They're seeing everything. And you know, that's where the organizing committee here have done a great job. They're making sure that the spectators are involved in the action all the time.
Big test coming up for Koukalová in particular. And not just because of the crowd, but because of her record so far this week. It has not been good in terms of shooting. She missed three on the stand in the sprint. She missed three in total in the pursuit, although she went from 13th to 8th. And crucially, Mike, that last standing shoot, that's what's so important. That's where so many races are won. And even if you've got a lead and you miss on that last shoot, your chances are dramatically reduced because it takes the sting out of your legs.
It hurts. Anything after the shoot, you just want to get back out there in the woods, go around that 2 kilometer track. But then you have this issue, this problem of the penalty loop.
Open range, as you say, unwritten rule that you don't overtake going down the back of the firing position. So Hauser can control the pace here.
Spectators respecting the fact they want this lady to have every possibility to hit another five. It's good to see Gasparin in the top five again today. Just 2 seconds behind.
Preuss fires early but misses. Hauser, 3 out of 3. Little delay between 3 and 4, but it doesn't affect the result. 5 out of 5. Koukalová is taking her time, as she did on the first prone. Now she's got to start believing in herself. That's 8 out of 8. Number 9 goes wide. That doesn't help her cause one little bit. What about Puskarčíková? She's missed 2. So Koukalová with a penalty loop. Hildebrand misses 2, as Dahlmeier did on the first shoot. Scardino gets 5. Durana Bear gets 5. She's back in the running, as is Vera. And Makarainen with another penalty loop to complete before she can get back out on the racetrack. Dahlmeier is in, taking her time this time, Mike, not rushing it.
Well, she got the adjustments prior to coming into the range. She's adjusted her sights. It's looking an awful lot better.
But 32 seconds has gone already. She's a long way down the range. I'm not sure she's going to be any closer than 45 seconds, and she might still be over 50 seconds behind.
You know, she's fatigued. Her mind is tired. Her body is tired. She's not quite the same biathlete. But there's still a chance to come back, I think, for Dahlmeier.
Birkeland missing 3. Ammonier of France missing 2. So the shooting standard, which has been remarkably high in the women's tour this year, dropping away. And I don't think we can really blame the wind. I think it's the fact it's the first mass start. Everyone's a little bit excited. The skiing's been very tough. And as you can see, the top 5 have all cleared 10 targets. Petrushina skiing a little slower, but 10 out of 10 will keep her happy. Let's have a look at the race leader. Little cant on the rifle for Lisa Teresa Hauser.
I love the way she shoots. One big breath in between each shot. She exhales and then squeezes her trigger on timing as the sights drift gently through the target.
Well, this is a different feel, isn't it? The short 2K loop compared to that 4K loop that they did earlier on. Out of the stadium, up the hill, back down under, and it's almost all done.
Look at the good recovery. So you can afford to attack that seriously 23% steep hill because you buy yourself this at least breathing recovery, maybe not recovery in the legs. And then it's the next climb. Then you've got another long recovery.
I remember watching Daria Domracheva go up that hill as though it was flat back in 2013. She just floated up it. That's where she was She'd already made a name for herself, but she really accelerated after that. We're hoping that Domrasheva is back at the midpoint of this season. Possibly she'll be in time and in shape for the World Championships in Hochfilzen.
Well, it was only, what, 1st of October, a little, sort of say, Marius, forget his little name, but when he was born, 1st of October, so I think January, maybe the end of January, she'll be back.
I thought Bjørgens was called Marius.
Yes, I've got the wrong one, Marit Bjørgen.
Chevalier now in fourth position, 4.7 down, so France, Germany, Russia, Austria, are they going to be the ones that share the podium positions, or will someone else get in there? Dorana Bear, 15 seconds behind. Her shooting has been okay, but she's missed one, so a 90% hit rate so far.
Koukalová's pulled back 12 seconds, and she's going to pull back more. That's 12 seconds to this point from the range.
Risky.
It is risky, but she knows she has to try and limit the damage that these three get away from her. Kimova has done nothing wrong, really, these last couple of days, and Nove Mesto.
Well, that's good for Lisa Teresa Hauser, I think, just to have someone, firstly, to help her on the snow, just share the pace, someone to feed off, and then, of course, it just reduces the pressure a little bit when you come in to shoot, because Hauser is not used to leading into the range area, and she's certainly not used to leading in front of 25,000 people.
She's not, but I think the pace needed to pick up, because, with respect, Lisa Teresa, she's not the fastest skier, she's like, what, 50 seconds over this full distance off the fastest pace. Dorana Bear, she's there, bib number three, way in the background. She's really closing the gap as well.
Look how much work comes off that left leg of Akimova on each stride, far more than we see from most of the others. 16 is Anais Chevalier, the winner from yesterday's pursuit. Dorana Bear is there. Koukalová is chasing, but at some stage, she's got to ease up. She's got to allow herself some recovery before the first stand. And I'm just starting to think we're going to see a similar shoot to the one we saw in the standing shoot in the sprint where she missed three. I hope not, but it's obvious that she's worked harder than anyone else on this lap.
Just thinking, Akimova has only missed three targets from the 30 shots fired at the previous 2 days of racing here.
Well, Foucault's domination in the men's, Mike, is impressive, but it's nowhere near as entertaining as the women's tour so far.
The women's tour has been great. They're swapping leaders, surprise leaders now and again. Big improvers like Lisa Teresa in second place.
Akimova, Hauser and Hinz. It's an unusual leaderboard, perhaps not the one that you would have predicted to be coming in at this stage. Two shoots remaining, both in the standing position, 10 targets to hit, and it's going to be Akimova on lane one for this first standing shoot. The snow just thickens up a little, not enough to affect the visibility or the sighting.
The ski poles quickly drop down onto the mat. Magazine in the housing, position stabilized.
Keep an eye on Koukalova's target. She's settling on the range now. First miss from Hauser. 4 out of 5 will keep her in the race. Akimova's missed, Hinz has missed, and now a chance for Anais Chevalier to move up. She doesn't take it. Dorana Bear is still clean. Koukalová's still clean. Will she get number 5? She does! Woo-hoo! Gabi Koukalová is going out, and she'll share the lead with Dorothea Wierer. Now the cream starts to float to the top. Incredible. Olsbu's got 5. One of Norway's best. It's not been a brilliant season for Olsbu. She's let herself down, usually with just one shoot in each race. And Kaisa Mäkäräinen won't be far off the pace. She'll join the chase. So suddenly, Mike, those who weren't used to being in front suffered from the pressure. Now the pressure switches to the big names. It's the Koukalovas, Wierers, Dorana Bears.
I love this sport. So much can change on this set as the pressure builds each time you come in to shoot. Hildebrandt, she's not really keeping it together today.
4 kilometers and 5 targets remaining in this, the last race before the Christmas period. Always good to head to Christmas Day with a win under your belt. It's got to be one of those top 10, surely. They're only 30 seconds apart. It could be any single one of them. I think Preuss will have to hope that Koukalová and Wierer missed two targets, but the rest are within that 25-second margin, which is what it takes to complete the 150-meter penalty. Hats off to Gabi Koukalová. That was a sensational shoot and a reminder that she skied that last lap quicker than anyone else. Now, Mike, she has to do it again because she's really used up her reserves. If it comes to a head-to-head on the last lap, you wouldn't really fancy her having the extra spark to take the win. So she's got to keep the advantage and she's got to get the same shooting score.
She has to get the same shooting score. As you're right, she really attacked the previous lap because of her poor shooting initially. She pulled a lot of that time back and she still managed to cope in the physical nightmare that she was in. She managed to keep the rifle stabilized.
Three of the biggest names from last year. Koukalová, of course, who won the overall World Cup last season. Dorana Bear, who was one of the golden girls of the World Championships in Oslo. She went home with three gold, two silver, one bronze. She lies in second place. And behind her, the Italian with so much promise, so much flair, Dorothea Wierer. In terms of shooting standard this year, Vera's on 81%, Dorana Bear on 79, and Koukalová on 73. So maybe it's going to be the Italian's day.
I don't think we can write Dahlmeier quite yet, write her off, although it is a big margin, it's 34 seconds. It depends what happens up the front here, but Dahlmeier not entirely out of a podium yet.
Well, we're going to see Dahlmeier making her move fairly soon. She'll try and close it down to something like 15. There she is, the yellow bib, Laura Dahlmeier, looking to secure win number 6 of the season and extend her lead in the World Cup standings.
Well, Dahlmeier, she's taken 9 seconds from the range off Koukalová. Is Koukalová tired this time, or is Dahlmeier really picking it up? I think she's picking it up.
A drink being taken on board by Laura Dahlmeier. It's not a long race, but at this stage of the weekend, three successive days of racing, you have to remember, for the women. So the men have had it a little bit easier with that break on Friday. Now, the margin's looking good, Mike. Koukalová is screaming out there.
Well, look at the support. She was saying yesterday how much it means to her to have so many people coming out supporting all the team, not just her. And it makes a difference. She said when you're in pain, you can almost push through that pain. And that's what she's doing today.
But gaining a couple of seconds on the track will mean nothing if she can't hit the 5 targets. What has she got to do? What's she got to do mentally to prepare herself for the next, 4 minutes of action?
I think she's relived this. Every athlete looks at, feels what's going to happen the next day. She's preempted a few scenarios. And I wonder if she's been planted into her mind the scenario that she leads in with a 6-second lead. Probably not. But she'll just focus on her breathing, on her stable position, and do her normal routine.
Dahlmeier's got it to 19 seconds from 30. So when she came out of the range after the last shoot, Dahlmeier was 34.9. Oof. She's closed it down to 19. Now just starting to settle down a little behind Olsbu and Makkarainen, but still tearing away at the front of the field is Gabi Koukalová. Now, it doesn't matter what happens from here, Mike, because the Czechs have, they've seen what they've come for. They'd love to see her win, but this has kept them on their toes all the way from the start of the race. They've been very, very patient.
And you know, I think just like last time, all this noise as she skis in, but they'll go dead quiet as soon as she lands on the shooting mat.
The last success the Czechs had here in their own stadium was the opening day of the World Championships in 2013 when they got a medal in the mixed relay. This would trump that. And actually, I think this could be the most important race in Gabi Koukalová's career. Certainly the most important 5 targets she's going to have to hit this year.
Andre Oribar.
Let's hope she's not as nervous as the coach.
He looks petrified.
The first one would settle the nerves. If she misses the first, surely game over.
They're on her case. Dorana Bear, Wierer. Wierer shoots fast.
And Dahlmeier, less than 15 seconds behind. got five, but so has Dorothy Vera. It's game on. We are having a ski race to the line. It's a rarity in biathlon. I'm not sure Dahlmeier can do anything about it. She'll know from the reaction of the crowd that Koukalová has cleared. Dahlmeier patiently, patiently waiting. What a matured performance by her. And now she's got to ski herself to success. 14 seconds the margin. The form we saw last week in Pachuca would suggest that Dahlmeier can do something about it, but you've got to remember that she put in a blistering pace on that last loop. So what she got left? 21.7 the margin. I'm not sure that's going to happen, particularly with Koukalová and Vera together out front. Now, Koukalová's looked the stronger of the two skiers, Mike, so far. Of course, Vera could have been saving herself, but the technique, the style has just been a little bit leaden compared to what we saw when Vera was at her best last year.
Well, Vera, but she's got this tenacious mindset. If she thinks she's got a chance of the top of the podium, she really kills herself to try and hold on to the athlete ahead of her.
2,000 meters to go. Well, the race is well and truly on. This is the only really severe climb coming out of the stadium. She's got a lead of some 15 meters. Is that going to be enough? We've seen some fallers. There's always the chance that Koukalová can take a tumble. Dorothy Vera can't do anything about it at the moment. The skis are good, but they're not good enough to close the gap. And she's too far back to benefit from the slipstream. One long climb still to go. If Vera can go into turbocharge, then she might just get in touch. But Koukalová looked so strong on this section last time around. And she didn't look to be pushing the limits to 100%. So I suspect there's still something left. And she wants it. There's no doubt that coming here this morning, Gabi Koukalová wanted this victory more than anyone else here in Nove Mesto. The win is on the cards. It's for hers to lose now. Another 60, 70 meters of climbing before she breaks left and then down towards the stadium. There's a little rise as she comes under the stands and up into the finishing straight. Koukalová ahead of Vera, the margin 5.8. And Laura Dahlmeier is still on the charge. 21 seconds behind at the start of this loop. She's claimed back 9 of those and got herself into the top 3. So minimal damage done in terms of the World Cup standings as far as Dahlmeier's concerned. But can she catch Dorothy Vera in the last 500 meters? Hinz, Olsbu, Preuss, all with good results compared to what they've produced this year. Again, Durand-Hubert found wanting in the closing stages. 2 misses in all from Durand-Hubert, the French champion. Hauser of Austria, who led early on, she's down in 8th. Makarainen 9, Akimova in 10, having missed 2. Makarainen, incidentally, missing 3 today. Koukalová, 19 hits out of 20. I can't see anyone who's hit the whole lot today. No one's gone clear, so 19 out of 20 matches the best in the range, and she certainly skied better than everyone else. From 5.4, Koukalová is now, what, 7-8 seconds clear, and I wonder whether she's had the warning about Laura Dahlmeier, who's just about to close up on Dorothy Vera of Italy. The Czech Republic lead with Gabi Koukalová. This will be her second victory of the season, but it's not over quite yet. From 12 to 6, and now with just 500 meters to go, Dahlmeier has not got a lot of uphill to play with. Koukalová is on her last legs. She knows it. The crowd know it. This is going all the way. 6 seconds, and I tell you what, Laura Dahlmeier will not hand this to the Czech. She's going to fight every inch of the way. It's the sight the fans wanted. 25,000 rise to their feet as Koukalová comes over the rise and into the last 150 meters. She's got it, but only just. Another 4 seconds and Laura Dahlmeier might well have claimed another win. But Koukalová wins in front of the home fans. She's wanted it so much for so long. At last, her dream has come true. 34:42, the winning time. Dahlmeier, a tremendous fight to get back up into second. What a day, what a race. Two Germans in the top four. Vanessa Hinz with her best of the season. And Marte Olsbu holding it together. 18 hits out of 20. Now she's done it. She knows she can do it. And I think we'll see more of those sort of performances later on in the season. The French looked dominant early on. They faded. Durana Bear 7. She finishes ahead of Kaisa Makarainen. Hauser, who led the second loop, shot so well in the prone position, 9th. And 10 is Akimova, who won the sprint 2 days ago. Norway's Tiril Ekhoff getting an 11th place, which is an improvement. It's not been a happy start to her season. And Justine Brezard of France coming in 12. Petrushna Vitkova getting an enormous cheer, finishing just ahead of Puskarchikova. Those two missing 3 apiece, actually, so that's 450 extra meters. Great scenes. Great, great scenes. Quite simply, we have to come back to Nove Mesto. The best racing, most dramatic, most emotional, the best crowd, brilliant tracks. There's nothing not to like here. This is what biathlon is all about. And so, so much credit to Koukalová, having had that meltdown in the sprint and a below average performance in the pursuit, 3 misses in both races. Today, she hits 19 out of 20. But the toughest of the lot were obviously those last 5 in the stand position, where she knew that if she hit 5, she had every chance of taking the win. Laukkanen, Magnussen, only 2:28 behind. It's not a bad margin. The women's field has closed dramatically. The competition at the front is fiercer than it's ever been. And let's hope it just gets better and better from here. What a world championships we're going to have down in Austria. Because I think as a result of this performance, there are going to be thousands and thousands and thousands of Czechs making their way down to Hochfilsen to see whether Koukalová or Vitkova, or of course Schlesinger or Sukup or Moravitz, to see whether they can medal at the big one. Honish of Poland looks disappointed with her run, and no wonder. She missed 5 targets. Equal worst shooting with Zima, who missed 5. Mary Laukkanen, who started so well, struggled with a standing shoot, missing 5. And this is Lena Heike, who we saw fall early. Actually, she's missed 6. And then Amonier of France has missed a total of 9. So I suspect that she had a tumble and affected the sights in some way. You can't win them all. You can't win them all, but she was in one of the best races we've ever seen. Well, she's a big enough name in the Czech Republic already, but there's no doubt that the sponsors will be queuing up to get their name on her sports gear. The number one winter sports star in the Czech Republic has produced the goods when it really mattered, at home. There's no need for words on an occasion like this. The pictures tell the whole story. Someone has to come first, someone has to come last. Today, It's Fanny Horn-Berkeland because Varvinets of Ukraine did not start. She was number 26. And Berkeland, what is she? Was 4:46 behind. She ends up 5:02 behind. 10 misses. Dreadful performance on the range. There may be a story behind it. We didn't see it. 100% of our attention was up the front of the race today. Well, the performance of the week, I wasn't going to give it to Martin Fourcade, his performance in the pursuit, which was quite majestic. But I think I'm going to switch the award. He's won enough. We'll give it to Gabi Koukalová for today's race. She will never experience more pressure than that unless they bring the Olympics to Nove Mesto. One or two interesting performances on the range, and some not as good as others, but 19 out of 20, the best we've seen. Koukalová did it, Wierer did it, Hinz did it. Only three hitting 19 out of 20, a 95% hit rate. Astonishing. We'll leave you with shots of Koukalová taking her second win of the season, but by far and away the most important one.
Thank you. Takže nás to nenecháme a přijde znova.